It is the most plentiful element in the universe, and it's a key component in the suite of renewable options needed as we transition to a cleaner, more secure energy strategy.
Hydrogen is a really important part of the portfolio of our energy in this country.
In nature, hydrogen is combined with other elements, but when separated, it is a powerful energy carrier. Used as a transportation fuel in zero-emission fuel cell vehicles. The National Renewable Energy Laboratory is developing and advancing a number of pathways to renewable hydrogen production.
One methodology of making renewable hydrogen is using biological means to break down lignocellulosic biomass.
Biomass is an array of abundant, sugar-rich, plant-based material. A fermentation process in the lab breaks down the complex sugars in biomass without oxygen to produce hydrogen.
In our group, we use a very novel bacterium that can directly ferment the very complex substrate and generate a lot of hydrogen.
Another promising pathway to renewable hydrogen is photobiological.
Photobiological process, in a way, is a parallel of the fermentation. The only difference is now the microbe has this unique capability to carry out photosynthesis.
In this case, pigments in water-grown algae and cyanobacteria absorb sunlight and generate hydrogen through photosynthesis. The challenge is that photosynthesis also releases oxygen, which inhibits hydrogen production.
NREL has been conducting research in overcoming that grand challenge by engineering some of the more oxygen-tolerant pathway into algae and cyanobacteria.
One thing is certain, sunlight is an effective way to break the bond between oxygen and hydrogen in water.
Water is our most rich resource in terms of hydrogen. And so the direct splitting of water is a holy grail way of making hydrogen.
We're in the photoelectrochemical hydrogen production laboratory, and our goal here is to turn sunlight and water into hydrogen fuel.
Scientists here use high-efficiency, multi-junction solar cells developed at NREL to split water.
So you shine light at it, and it pushes electrons out the front, and it reduces protons into hydrogen, and that's what you can see bubbling off the surface.
This is one of the cleanest pathways to convert water to hydrogen. The goal now is to make electrolyzing water to hydrogen more cost competitive with other fuel sources.
The potential is limitless. I mean, we have tons of sunlight and we have tons of water on our planet, so we could expand our energy economy to meet however many people we put on this planet in a renewable fashion with no byproducts.
In my opinion, renewable electrolysis is really the ultimate end goal. If you're using solar or wind-powered electricity to power your electrolyzer, you now have, in the case of transportation, a renewable transportation fuel, and that's a huge success. That's a big departure from where we are today.
Hydrogen is an exceptional energy carrier, much like electricity, which makes it ideal for transportation with zero carbon emissions.
The energy in hydrogen is stored in tanks on a fuel cell electric vehicle, and the fuel cell itself is the engine that provides the power, and you're feeding it hydrogen to move down the road.
Think of a fuel cell as like a battery. It's got a bunch of layers all sandwiched together, and when the hydrogen comes in, it reacts with oxygen from the air and creates water, H2O, and electricity and heat. But unlike a battery where the energy is stored in the plates, the energy is actually stored in the gas coming in.
Hydrogen fuel cell technology is in use today, offering high productivity with fast refueling for equipment like forklifts. And hydrogen fuel cell vehicles are emerging in the transportation market.
They run on hydrogen, they can be refueled in 3 to 5 minutes, run 300 or 400 miles, and then be refueled again in 3 to 5 minutes. So an exact replacement as far as a consumer is concerned for a car that can meet their everyday needs.
What's different is a fuel cell is 2 to 2.5 times more efficient than the gasoline engines we drive around in today.
Researchers at NREL's Energy Systems Integration Facility are evaluating and improving the hydrogen and fuel cell infrastructure.
It's a 6-axis robot intended to simulate a human refueling a car.
To enhance the consumer experience and ensure safety.
Hydrogen is a safe fuel. It's very predictable. It's light, and so when it escapes, it does go up and kind of get out of the way.
NREL works closely with academic and industry partners with the shared goal of realizing the full potential of hydrogen technologies.
Really, our partnership with industry is critical because they tell us what the problems are, and we work on them in the lab with them and with their inputs, and then we hopefully feed that back out in industry to get better products on the market.
It's really exciting to be in this field. I mean, I feel lucky that I get to come to work and do something I believe in every day and be on the cutting edge of this technology.
The National Renewable Energy Laboratory is transforming the way we power our country to reduce our dependence on fossil fuels and lessen our impact on the environment.
We actually have to push forward now. It's really critical that NREL is involved today to help the research and development on making low-cost, renewable hydrogen.
Renewable hydrogen, unlocking and exploring its power, is a crucial element of our clean energy future.